this problem, we're going to be looking at a subspace of three-dimensional space R3. So the question is, suppose that u equals the vector 1, 0, minus 2, and v is the vector 1, 2, 3. We have to show that this set, the set of all x in R3, such that x equals lambda u plus mu v, for lambda and mu in R, is a subspace of R3. Now, geometrically, what that means is that, well, here's our three-dimensional space, and here's, say, the vector u, and here's the vector v. Now, when we're considering things like this, we're taking linear combinations. For example, 1/2 u plus 1/3 v would be that vector there. And this is the set of all such possible linear combinations, which forms a plane through the origin, containing the two vectors u and v and all possible combinations of them. Okay, so to solve this problem, we use the subspace theorem. The subspace theorem tells us how to prove that something is a subspace. So there are basically three things that we have to check. We have to check that the subset is, first of all, not empty, that there's at least something in it. We have to show that it's closed under addition and that it's closed under scalar multiplication. If we can do those three things, then it's a subspace. All right, so let's start with the first condition. And we want to show that the set is non-empty. And the easiest way of doing that is to show that the zero vector is in that set. So since the zero vector can be written as 0u plus 0v, we see that the zero vector is in the set S. So S is non-empty. As a set, it has at least one element in it. In fact, it also has u and v in it, but we only need one element to show that it's non-empty. For the second property, we need to show that S is closed under addition. So for that, we need to take two vectors in S and add them and see that the result is still in S. So suppose that x1 and x2 are both in S. What does that mean? So it means that we can write x1 as, say, lambda 1 u plus mu 1 v, and x2 equals lambda 2 u plus mu 2 v. For some numbers, lambda 1, u1, lambda 2, mu2 in R. So that's what it means for this vector and this vector to be in S. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to add those two vectors. So now x1 plus x2, well, if we add these two vectors, then we have lambda 1, u plus mu 1 v, that's the first vector, and then the second vector is lambda 2 u plus mu 2 v. And then we use the rules of manipulation of vectors in a vector space to be able to rewrite this. So we'll bring the multiples of u together and write it as lambda 1 plus lambda 2 u plus and mu 1 plus mu 2 v. We brought these two together and factored out the lambda 1 plus lambda 2, and we brought these two together and factored out the mu 1 plus mu 2, and doing that we've used the various familiar rules for manipulation in a vector space, namely the fact that things are commutative and distributive. And now that we see we have something like this, well, we can see that it's obviously in S because it's something times u plus something else times v. And similarly, if we have a look at the same vector x1 and we multiply that vector x1 by lambda, then we get lambda times lambda 1 u plus mu 1 v. And that's then lambda times lambda 1 u plus lambda times mu 1 v. Again, because of the distributivity of the scalar multiplication. And when we've written it that way, we see we have, again, a multiple of u and a multiple of v added together. So this is also in S. And so therefore, S is non-empty and closed under both addition and scalar multiplication. It is thus a subspace.